Aries, it's me, Stormy, and here is your horoscope for 2020. So first of all, welcome to your annual horoscope. It's exciting to look around, see what's happening, what's coming up in the year, especially in such a big astrological year. We've got great things happening. We've got three pretty big events going on. We've got Saturn and Pluto coming together in conjunction. We've got Jupiter and Pluto coming together in conjunction. Then we'll have Saturn and Jupiter coming together in conjunction, plus every planet that can will retrograde this year. So it is a hopping good time. And then we'll throw in a United States election, which is always exciting for all of the world. So lots of good stuff going on, but let's jump in here and talk about what impact it's going to have in your world so that you have a little bit of a view as we move into 2020. Now, first of all, Mercury will retrograde three times this year, like it does every year. So we'll see those retrogrades happening in February, June, and October. And I will cover those in the monthly videos and in smaller breakdowns. One thing you can do, though, is look back to the Mercury retrograde in your element video that I made in 2019, because all of the retrogrades will be happening in water energies again this year. So you'll definitely be able to kind of have that same feel of what you were experiencing a little bit last year. Now, this year we're going to have six eclipses as opposed to our traditional four, and we kick these off right at the beginning of the year. So on January 10th, there's going to be a lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer. So this is going to light up the fourth house space for you. This is home, family, real estate, property, your emotional security and stability. So with this lunar eclipse here, the lunar eclipse gives us about 6 months worth of impact. So over the next 6 months, the first 6 months of the year, you may be able to see changes to your domestic space. Maybe you're moving, maybe a person's moving out, maybe you're doing something different with your housing space in some way, shape, or form. I definitely think with this eclipse being in Cancer energy as well, you could see things happening with your parents or your family, so kind of keep an eye on that as well. But the other thing that's happening this year with this fourth house business for you is much of a continuation of 2019, except for you've already put in the work. So if you've been putting in the work in 2020, you get to start to see some of the spoils of your hard work, right? So here, your emotional stability, your foundations that you've been building this identity and life on, you could see them coming to fruition in a different way over this next 6 months, and it looks to be very, very positive. Now, on January 12th, we're going to have Saturn and Pluto coming together in their conjunction at 22 degrees of Capricorn. This is going to light up your 10th house. So again, we see that the axis for you, especially at the beginning part of the year, Aries, continues in this home and family zone and work zone. So houses 10 and 4 will continue to be lit up. Now, Saturn and Pluto coming together in this conjunction, first of all, is a big deal because it happens only every 34 years. And when they do come together, especially because they're such heavy hitters, what happens is Saturn is trying to bring you to the next level. Pluto is helping you die off in some way so that you can rise to your magic, right? But this is a slow evolutionary process that happens. It literally has to destroy some old foundations, old ideas, old structures that you've had in your life in order for the new ones, Pluto energy, to come through and to be built up. Now, this doesn't always happen with the greatest sense of ease. This particular conjunction may put you in the position where you're coming to this transition, and it's a little bit hard. You're feeling like there's a little bit of loss, or you're feeling like something just doesn't quite fit, and you're trying to answer the question in the work zone as to where is the official Aries space. Even if you've been hustling and you've been working in this zone and you found yourself at a place that you're feeling comfortable, you may still be looking for a little bit of that perfect tweak, and this particular energy will help you do that. What I can tell you is that no matter what is coming for you in the work zone, in the home zone, just make sure you're prepared, right? Be prepared in 2020, and that will save you a lot of heartache. All right, March 22nd, we see Saturn taking a dip forward into the energy of Aquarius. Now, Saturn coming into Aquarius is going to light up your 11th house. And these are interesting energies to put together anyways. Saturn wants to create structure. The Aquarian energy ruled by Uranus is like, let's break it down. These don't work. So this is a perfect kind of combination for you to be joining new social groups, cleaning out those friends. If you've had connections to social groups, organizations, friendships, dreams, ideas, beliefs for yourself that don't fit anymore, Saturn is leveling you up. Remember, he's a maturing energy. He says, okay, I'm taking you to the next level. So with this energy, he's taking your friendships, your organizations, your social sphere, your even online social communities to another level. And more than that, I love this energy because it shows you that you can have a bigger dream than maybe the one you had, or perfect the one that you feel like you want in the first place. So this is a really delicious energy. Now, this is just a preview of what is going to come as Saturn officially moves into Aquarius. This is just a little snack treat, little situation. And it's going to be here from March until July, and then Saturn will retrograde and run back into Capricorn. So it's like he's going to come back over and check and make sure you've been doing the work on the career and getting steady there. And then in December, he'll pop forward into Aquarius until 2023. Now, we've also got Jupiter and Pluto coming together in conjunction with each other three different times this year, April, June, and November. Now, we love this. We are here for this. When Jupiter and Pluto come together, this is like Jupiter's not comfortable in Capricorn, but that's okay. He feels restricted here, but he's still willing to bring some blessings. So when Jupiter and Pluto come together, because it's in a Capricorn energy, it is like you get a focused amount of drive. You get power, you get opportunities, you get movement that's happening right here, and you're ready to leap forward to them. So make sure you take advantage when these focused energies come up for you. So you'll see it April 4th, June 30th and November 12th. Whatever needs your action and attention, take advantage of that. And the work that you've been doing, any place that you've had a loss, you may also see the universe starting to fill this in, right? I told you, Saturn's going to come take some things out of your life, and it's equally going to have this energy to replace it with the best version for you as well. All right, May 13th through June 25th, we've got Venus going into retrograde in the energy of Gemini. This is going to light up your third house space. Now, first and foremost, with a Venus retrograde, we highly suggest, if you can avoid making a major investment or getting married or starting a brand new relationship, which who can control that, right? But if you can avoid those things, it's best that you do, because when Venus comes out of retrograde, it's typically not what it seemed. And it's, you know, it's life. You're going to do what you're going to do, and you've got to have the experiences you've got to have. But we just try and give you a little bit of heads up. Now, Aries, because this is also in your third house, I would highly suggest not signing any new contracts. The third house is the house of communication, decision making. You're seeing dollar signs, or you're thinking it's going to be terrible, right? You're just maybe not as clear on your whatever judgment in this negotiation as you could be. Other things that do happen is we have to relook at finances. Because it's the third house, maybe you're making some new financial decisions, right? Maybe you're having to communicate around something around finances. Certainly, it could be, let's say you're relocating and you need to sign that lease for the house. That's fine. Read all the details and then do what you need to do. But relationships and money do typically come under tension in a Venus retrograde as well. But it only lasts until June 25th, and then we can get on with our lives. June 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Sagittarius at 15 degrees. This is interesting because it's in the ninth house place for you. So having this eclipse tells me there's fresh training, fresh education, maybe even just some travel coming up on your agenda at this particular time. But you've got 6 months of stamp on this. You're going to be taking advantage and maybe focusing in on this area for the next 6 months. So something else I kept thinking is, if you wanted to publish a book, wanted to do a YouTube channel, teaching something in the energy of Sagittarius, maybe you want to teach. Sag loves to gather information and then give it away. So in some way, shape, or form, your ninth house area, I'm just getting a vision of law. Maybe something legal's coming up. You've got Venus, who's been in retrograde in your third house, maybe there is a contract on your table, or something legal could just be coming up as well, because it's ninth house matters. Anything with international travel, you could start to see having some attention there, or communication or something like that. Now, on June 21st, we've got a solar eclipse at 0 degrees of Cancer, so again in the fourth house. And then on July 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse in Capricorn at 13 degrees, so again, your 10th house. That fourth house, 10th house, home and family versus work, these guys are working together. At this solar eclipse, you're going to get a fresh start in this fourth house. This could be the official move. We found the place, we've moved in, we're breathing new life into it. It could be that you find your place at work, or you find a place on this planet that feels like home. I do, again, think because it's got so much Cancerian energy, you need to pay attention to your parents or the female figures into your life. Ooh, I love that. Maybe there are women coming into your life that will be very, very helpful. At the lunar eclipse, you could have interactions with males or more male energies that are helping you make changes or corrections to your career in some way. That lunar eclipse that happens on July 5th is going to be brilliant for helping you in a business idea, scene, or situation somewhere down the road. Now, if you are retired and you're like, I'm not working, this eclipse will also help you start something fresh that you want to be involved with. September 9th through November 13th, we've got Mars retrograde, but he's retrograde in the energy of Aries. So this is nice. He's in his home sign, not completely uncomfortable or anything like that, but he is still retrograde. So when Mars goes into retrograde, my number one recommendation is please do not have surgery. Mars is over war and cutting, surgery, the surgeon, that is war because you are cutting that body, right? So we recommend that you don't have surgeries if you can avoid that. And it's happening in your first house. It's in your sign. So one of the things a retrograde Mars can do for you is help you go back over you. How are you moving? What energy and action are you taking? Are you taking care of your physical body, right? How are you showing up in public? What are you getting to be known for, right? Mars will help you go back over your desires, what you want, what you need. It'll help you go back over your energy. How are you spending that? How are you using that? It'll help you also go back over your identity, right? Aries, this is the deal. We're a whole nother year older. Do you have this idea of you that is outdated? Right? And it needs to come current. Who are you now currently? Mars will help you see that in this particular energy. And of course, to finish up anything that needs to be finished up, if you need to get that passport, whatever it is that benefits you, it'll help you go back over those things, okay? November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in Gemini. This is going to be at 8 degrees. So again, this third house is back on the table. But then December 14th, we've got a solar eclipse in Sagittarius. So now the third and ninth house cusps become lit up at this point in the year. So now it's not so much intense focus on home and career. You're going to start to get some energies that pop up and start to express for you in your thinking houses, your decision-making houses, your communication houses. This is the book. This is the project. This is the website. This is meeting new clients. This is that international travel or business. I also think teaching and studying. If you need to teach, if you need to study something, take more training so you have those skills. These are your eclipses that will help you do that. And again, anything around contracts and legal, look for these energies to support you. December 17th, we see Saturn jumping back into the energy of Aquarius now, and it's going to be here until 2023. So you can start to plan to focus on feeling responsibility, obligation, heavier energy that's going to take you to the next level with Saturn coming into this zone. And for everybody, that's not going to be necessarily comfortable. Sometimes when Saturn comes and says you cannot be connected to this thing anymore, this organization, and you find out it's just not right for you, that can be a little bit heartbreaking. But at the same time, remember, the universe never leaves a hole. It's gonna pull in what's best for you as long as you allow that. On the 20th, we see Jupiter into Aquarius. Oh, hey, Jupiter. So again, we've got benefit and expansion to your 11th house. Now, on the 21st, Saturn and Jupiter are going to come together. This is called the Great Conjunction. And when these two come together, they're called the ruler of the age. So as we move into the age of Aquarius, we will see these guys as our guiding forces. They have a lot to do with economics, politics, religious issues. Saturn is law and order. Jupiter is wisdom and expansion. So as these two come together here on the 21st in this great conjunction, in the energy of Aquarius, who is kind of the rebel, the let's do it different energy, surprise, this is going to be a turning point for all of us, in your social connections, in your voice. Because Aries, you may even find yourself in that fourth and 10th house axis feeling like, I need to run for office. I need to be more of a voice in my community. I have a cause. I have a passion. I have a purpose. Whatever it is, this particular energy globally is a turning point for us from some of the chaos we've been seeing. It'll start to bring new solutions for sure. But for you personally, it will put you in a position to show up in the independent, unique voice that you have that also acts as, you act as a salve to some kind of chaos or to some kind of wound that's been happening. So this is a big, delicious energy. And I really would encourage you, think back, Aries, between 2012 and 2015 when Uranus and Pluto were dancing together. What were you doing? What were you starting to come awake to? Because that is a little snick snack snippet as to what your cause may be, what you're actually passionate about, but you've now had the time to develop the self and to develop the information to go be passionate about this. So I look really forward to seeing how you make the connections through your year and allow these areas to light up for you. Now, of course, this is a brilliant general reading, which is going to be useful for so many out there. But if you want to know what your year is going to look like, make sure you book an appointment with me, with somebody. Go sit down with somebody and see what your personal year is going to look like, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to traveling with you every month and every week, bringing you tons of details, teaching all year long, and just supporting you in your life and in your learning. All right, you guys, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.